Hi, I'm David.
And I'm Jasmine. And this is our first Q&A.
So today we're going to have a Q&A.
But first, some breakfast. Some joint juice. I got an acai bowl. This is a new addition from joint juice, so we'll just kind of taste. Yeah.
And they also started with matcha latte with oat milk and vanilla syrup. So let's see. I don't know if I have faith in it, but I guess we'll figure out if it's good or not.
And I ordered the pick me up. It's like strawberries, banana, and apple.
Okay, I'm gonna try the matcha. It's actually not that bad. I like it.
Good job, Jun Ju.
I had really like low expectations. I also ordered a tuna caddo.
Alright, well, we have our breakfast. We asked you guys to leave some questions down below, and also we us on Instagram as well, so if you want to follow us on Instagram, you can do that. Her app is here, my app is here. Okay, let's answer some while we eat.
One of the most asked questions that we had was, how did you guys meet?
How did we meet?
So we went to the same dance school, yeah. Which was Quick Style Studio. Shout out Quick Style Studio. But we didn't know each other then. And then fast forward some years, my best friend Abdi.
Shout out Last Abdi.
Yeah, shout out Last Abdi. He basically asked me to meet him one day. Like, he was already hanging out with some guys, which I did not know at that time.
And those guys that Abdi were supposed to meet is actually Vimo today. Back then we were different members, but we had like Omar and all, and me obviously. So we met with Abdi. And then he brought some friends. One of them was Jasmine, and she was really like this cool, mysterious like girl. I always had a sense and a vibe like from the first meet, you know? But it wasn't like anything romantic. We started out as friends, really good friends, because I really liked her like low-key chill vibe, and I respected her style a lot.
I used to be so quiet, like...
super quiet, but... once you got to know her, and once you got to see like who she really was and her personality, it was really like the most wholesome, like warm feeling, like almost like someone breaking out of their shell and just like blooming into a beautiful flower. And I got to witness that by becoming one of her really good friends back then.
Hey! I hate birds. I just remember him being like the center of the group. So if he was like, let's go there, then everyone's like, okay, let's go there. And if we said like, let's go to the beach, everyone was like, okay, let's go to the beach. So you were the leader of the group, basically. And I also thought that you were very good at talking. And you were also a very good dancer. I thought it was really cool that you were such a good dancer. You were very kind. You were a comfortable guy to be around. What's gonna be your posting schedule? I need to know because I love watching y'all. First of all, thank you so much.
Thank you.
So our posting schedule will be every Wednesday at
6 p.m. CEST.
Yeah, we will try to stick to that. But like, that's the plan.
How do you guys decide on which place to eat? That's a really difficult question because we ask each other that every day.
The thing is, I always want sushi bowl. Like papaya salad or pho, and he always wants burgers.
The thing is, when you grow up in a like Vietnamese household, you get a lot of Vietnamese food, obviously. Like they know how to make Thai food as well, Chinese food. So I'm like used to all of those dishes at home. And sometimes it's even better at home. For me, it's like getting more variations when I'm outside eating. It's a more refreshing feeling. It's a really difficult task every single time. Sometimes we even crave the same, but that's really, really rare. Right?
Are you guys directors?
We're both directors in our own way. She's a creative director and I'm film director. What is the difference, you may ask? Creative directors are more like in charge of a creative team. It's often more in campaigns and commercials.
I'm a self-claimed creative director.
Same, self-claimed film director. You just have to claim it and then work towards that goal, towards that role. Mm-hmm. I think that's the way we have been working, at least. And just experiencing how and failing and then just climbing and trying to figure out like the whole process behind it.
I actually did my first campaign video as a creative director. I think it was last year, but we launched the project this year.
Yeah, just recently actually.
Yeah.
It's on vimo.no, the Instagram. That's the name of our creative company together with Omar and Kunal.
So you can check that out if you would like to.
And film director is in the name itself. It's like the one who's in charge of the vision and film of a movie. That's what I'm aspiring to create and direct one day.
I was just gonna say the reason I'm like looking around like is because these birds, seagulls, they're crazy here.
Yeah, we have to be on the lookout every single time.
Because we've been victims.
Oh yeah, we have been victims. Like, and the technique that they do is so like, it's so well thought, you know?
Yeah, I'm the bird. You hold this. So they
are
do
so
this.
Smart. They're so intellectual.
Intellectual.
I'm just minding my own business. Or I'm Yasmin right now.
Oh, burger. Gun.
They use their feet like this. And they push you.
Yeah. They make you lose your balance. Like this. So that you lose your grip on the food, and then they take the food.
They grab the food and they fly away and they enjoy our food.
For free.
Free. And we're not even sponsored, so we have to pay for the food. Or...
Bro, say... No, they're...
Yeah. They do this thing that they go around you, you know, they scout the area and they kind of distract you, so they work in pairs. One is distracting you, I bet there's another. Yeah, there's another one there.
Oh,
I knew it.
God.
I knew it. That one there is the UAV. So we'll quickly finish up our breakfast so that the birds don't take it from us, and then we'll keep on asking your questions. See you soon. Side of Oslo.
Yes.
Lara Sitis. Lara Fakis. Sitis. The detail looks good. It's good. You know what I mean? It's a cool summer.
Yeah, it does.
Alright, guys. We're currently at the seaside of Oslo. It's called Akebrygge.
Yes.
It's a beautiful, beautiful location. We used to come here. When we first started dating.
Yeah, we took like long walks here.
Back here, I just wanted to show this place with you guys. And let's answer the next question.
What country haven't you traveled to that you would love to go to? I think like we were actually, after Japan, we were planning to go to Singapore and Bali. We've been to Bali, but we haven't been to Singapore, and we have thought about traveling there for the longest time. So I think, but we're broke right now. After Japan, we're broke. So I definitely think that the next vacation will be Singapore. Yeah. What about you?
So for me, I think a place that I really want to travel to, obviously, we love Asia, you probably know by now, or if you follow us on other socials, you probably know that we love travel to Asia. Our plan was actually to travel to Singapore and also Jakarta in Indonesia, but that plan got cancelled because we're broke.
Bye.
Vi skulle ikke til Indonesia, vi skulle til Singapore.
Og Jakarta?
Nei, Singapore og Bali.
Okay, so she's saying that we were supposed to go to Bali, but I strongly believe it was Jakarta.
You? Hello, vi skulle dit! Hello,
okay, right? Uansett, det jo Indonesia, uansett.
Ja, men Bali helt annerledes.
Okay, anyways. Singapore and Indonesia, all right? But we're broke. So, that's how we're broke. But a place that I really, really want to go to for a long time now that has been on my bucket list for I don't know how long is Australia. So I think, I don't know if that's the next location or not. It's just like a one place that I really want to go to.
Let's settle this once and for all, okay guys?
Just once and for all.
So the question is, what are your ethnicities? You can start.
My dad is from Vietnam, my mom is from Taiwan, which means that I'm half Vietnamese and half Taiwanese. But my mom grew up in Vietnam, so we always speak Vietnamese at home. We never speak like Mandarin or Cantonese. What about you?
So I am from Sudan. Yeah, I'm from Sudan. I don't have anything more to say.
So, another question. How old are you guys? She's...
I am 23, turning 24.
Which makes her a 99 model.
Yes.
And I'm 1 year older, which makes me a 98 model.
What is one thing you both learned from each other? I can start. One thing I learned from David is... only one thing? That's hard. But I would say... patience. One thing I learned from him is also to be confident in my work and to be confident in myself, I would say.
Because you're great. One thing that I've learned from Jasmine, I would say Jasmine often reminds me to live in the now and just enjoy and remember to have fun with things, you know? It doesn't always have to be work. You need to balance, and that's when you can do your best at work. So, thank you for that. So it's super hot outside, we decided to ride the bike. Another question that we got is, who plans the better date? It's pretty like equal, like we're really good at planning dates, I feel. But Jasmine is great, I will give her credits though. She's a really good planner.
I think I do. Or to me, I'm the one who plans the better dates. Because I usually have like, I research a lot beforehand. I'm like, okay, what does Dave like to eat? What is it that we haven't eaten in a long time? And then I'm like, okay, let's try a new restaurant.
All right, my bike died, so let's go.
Yeah,
so many.
One ice cream?
Yeah, one ice
yeah?
cream.
Yeah, you will share it?
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so next question is, what language do you guys communicate in? And the answer is Norwegian. We talk to each other in Norwegian. Yeah, so it's like when we talk English to each other, it's kind of awkward, but it's we manage.
Yeah, yeah, we'll get used to it. We try to get used to it.
Have ice cream, enjoy.
Hi, yes, we come to know them. Oh.
Let's see who can take the better picture. Okay, you lifted your angle right away.
This is my setup.
Oh, that is your prop?
Yeah, yeah. Okay,
so here is my picture. Who do you think had the best ice cream pictures?
This is an interesting question. I like this one. If you could be the other one for just one day, what would be the first thing you'd do?
if I'm lasting for one day,
what would be the first thing you would
wear? Really, really bad clothes, like style myself so awfully, just to see how Jasmine would rock that. And even then, I think like her aura would rock that, you know? Because she's like the presence of her is different. But it would be interesting to see how that would look like, you know? Don't you agree? Because she always looks like so nice.
The first thing I would do, I would jump out the bed and I would start dancing.
What?
Because he's a good dancer. I would dance the sickest choreographies. Like
on the bed.
Not on the bed, jump out of the bed.
Oh.
And then I would dance.
I thought you meant like dance on the bed.
I would go and dance the hardest choreography that he's ever done.
Okay, yeah, that's cool. Good answer. Okay, so let's try for something different. Yeah, okay. If you could go anywhere in the world, like, where would it be?
Japan.
I just said like right before I asked this question. But yeah.
Japan.
Okay. We have another interesting question, which is Quincy single and ready to mingle?
Yeah. The answer
is, or at this moment, it is yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Slide in.
Slide into his DMs. Here's his
at.
Favorite project that you guys have been working together on?
David's new short film.
Yeah, I would say so too. Because that's the most recent one.
Yeah.
It's the third short film and it will come out, I think, beginning of the next year. Hopefully. So you'll see that when it comes out.
Elizabeth, which is David's sister.
Shout out
Elizabeth.
My sister.
She asked, who eats the most spicy food?
100%. Yes. But it's not like I can't eat spicy.
No, you can eat spicy too.
Yeah.
But I can eat spicier.
Yeah, I think it's just like the reaction. I think you still feel the numbness to it. But for me, I get like this. I start to shiver and I start to sweat. My whole body control is out of like.
Yeah, if it's the most spicy.
Yeah, I start to do like. Him. So we're just gonna drink up our juice and then move on to our next location.
So we're answering the last questions now. Marwa, which is my family.
Shout out
Marwa. she asks, what's your fashion inspiration?
Ooh.
And the thing is that...
$1 million question.
I would say that it doesn't specifically come from... I don't have anything specific where it comes from, I feel like. It's people, it's places, it's architecture, it's art, it's everything, basically. Nature, it could be anything. So I feel like... I don't have like any specific thing, but I feel like I get inspired a lot from traveling also.
For me, it's always been about like silhouettes.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to learn more and more and more about my own style. And a lot of my influence come obviously from her and just seeing how she approaches like the combinations of things.
And colors.
And also the colors. I think also a lot of my inspiration comes from like Japan in general, like the country, just the country. And how they dress up there and how they approach fashion there.
I love Japanese fashion. Our very last question is, what is your proudest moment? Asked by Umar from our company.
Our brother, shout out.
Yes. I would say my proudest moment is definitely my first work as a creative director, which is a minor. That was the first time I was able to finish something like from start till the end because of our team, our beautiful team.
Yeah,
I would say
that's a great moment. I think for me, my proudest moment at this very moment would be when we got accepted the application that was sent in for the short film, you know, and that was like a huge like accomplishment for us because we've never get funded in any of our projects before, and that's like a team feeling as well because we all put our efforts into that application.
You work hard.
But yeah, I'm really proud of that moment.
I'm proud of him.
and I'm proud of her.
Thank you so much for watching, and thank you for the support on our last video as well. We hope to see you next time, next Wednesday at 6 CEST. Let's go.
Hope you like this Q&A. Hope that you learn a little bit more about us. And yeah, see you in the next episode, right?
Yes.